fun. Female breeding and find your elephant, work on a matriarch society. The lady's in charge of the herd, big mama. She's got all the kids with her and other females. And the young bulls at that puberty, about the age of 14, they get kicked out by big mama, basically. Getting a bit out of hand, chatting up all the young girls, just like old kids did. Yeah? Sit on the back of the animals, develop a screeching voice, got really long claws and actually clamber all around the animals, taking ticks and parasites off, and act like an early warning system. It's one of the best sounds to listen for when you're looking for a rhino walking through that simple. You just listen for this screeching, it's a harsh screech as soon as they see us, or any predator, they fly off screeching. Lovely bush bucks, all right. And then you can hear the screeching call. That's the oxpeckers warning the animals in danger. Hear that? You hear that in the thick bush. See the size of that nest, the bushy bell. The ear sort of sticks right in front of it. Right up there. From the balls rejoin the herd. Thank you. people saw that they did that before. Stopped at 5 o'clock the other day, actually saw three riding in the bike train. Same size, quite narrow. Line is usually. Line is sort of like this. It's the back of the pants. Double the size of anything else. Left there, I was in the middle of the
prevailing wind that the wind blowing northwesterly. Follow the wind and get the wind in the direction. And obviously the sun is still traveling up. Pretty safe as long as you walk with the wind and you want to start heading up and end up on the lake somewhere.
Thank you.
actually friendly. That's a new. They make a little sign of my friendly for your age.
Come to me, everyone.
All you can hear is just the breaking of the trees. It's a breathing head going through. And the easiest way is to sort of pick up where the animals are, let's say, moving through the bush, is just to stand and watch for the cattle egress. You know the elephants are there, but where are the animals? The animals. And also, they sometimes they act, most of the time they act as early warners to the animal.
You
sort of hear them sort of going, chah! Especially when you pick up rhino or buffalo. You must have heard them at Water Wilderness.
Yeah.
They go, chah!
Yes.
And you know, you must look around.
They're babies.
Yeah. It's either you see a buffalo or you see an elephant. Or you see...
There's
a baby running. Must have been dragging behind and now it feels a bit upset. And then you come and sit. Just sit and watch the elephant. You actually find all the stuff that she mentions in this book relates to what you're looking at. And very correctly as well.
Start to understand that their studies with domesticated animals in zoos were, was totally inaccurate.
Yeah.
When?
It was only recently, after the completion of this book that Cynthia Moss wrote on the African elephant, the Elephant Memories. It's a recent book that has just been produced, and that's when everybody then sort of picked up that there's a lot of mistakes that you made.
I didn't realize it was that recent.
Oh, it's quite recent, yes. You say, okay, fine, I'm now living in confinement for an indefinite period. I lose a lot of, you know,
it's reasonable.
Touch
to
the sort of normal human behavior because I'm living in a different situation. I've got a lot of restrictions.
A comparison is like prisoners, people who spend
same thing.
A lot of time
that's
in prisons, they go back in normal society and they can't cope.
They can't cope.
Yeah.
It's very difficult to rehabilitate because that sort of effect of the confinement, restriction, affects you.
But on a short lifespan even.
That could have been a result of the crocodiles when she was too young. She's doing pretty well, that is being caused by elephants. Now, at the same time, you can see the new shoots that are shooting up. Now, those new shoots actually benefit to the antelopes, which are much shorter. Although we do say elephants are very destructive animals, at least they do save part of their job to enable the small antelopes to reach to the browse, especially the principal browse. Whereas if these trees had been growing straight up without any effect by the elephants, that means they could be in here. Would have been striving in the bush path. indecision. Indecision. Did you see that?
Yeah.
He was thinking of, let's say, mock charging. But now he knew that that guy was coming. They spoke to each other and then he decided to give a shake. So he had a lot of indecision. Either to challenge the guy or to challenge us. You see? That's the stance now. To challenge that other guy. You know, the humble is bad, you know. You see him pulling the branch off the road. He's cross. Just wants to. He's gonna use a check. He's going to hit that other guy with it. You see? You see that? Sort of thought about it, looked around, investigated, and now your class is over. Our rains, it will cover up again. Now, that's quite an old tree there, about over this 90, 100 years or more. Old, but they've been actually peeling it off slowly, slowly. And eventually the wind actually pushed it. It dropped off. elephant neutralized it fully. I mean, all the branches were right up to here, but they've neutralized it fully. They're still going for it. He then started feeding, so he relaxed after that, and then he started feeding, and after feeding he then sort of moved. One of us must have moved so quickly that he picked up a flash of a movement, right? Now they don't like that. They know that you've done so, and we actually sort of give the respect that they deserve, and in turn they return it by not charging him.
Thank you. mind. Perhaps just...
Thank you.
good.
The work on it.
The younger females are lighter, and the darker ones. But look at those two there, you see the difference in colour between that black one and the younger female next to her.
Mm.
But it's a very old animal that goes pitch black.
And the male?
The male goes jet black.
Jet black?
Jet black. Much bigger horn, curving back. Now they had a lot of calves this year. They've lost both of them.
Could we be any closer to them at a different time?
Yeah. Do you tell could get a little closer, but I don't really want to disturb them. Perhaps, you know, they could be 20 yards closer, but they're fairly relaxed like that. They just don't seem to be going off. What I can do is just go along with them.
Me say meow meow.